Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, like I told you in our previous tutorial, we are going to close off our HTML and CSS crash courses by creating a simple website layout. And that's exactly what we are going to be doing in this tutorial. So in this tutorial, we are going to be creating something like this. So after we are done with this tutorial, you will know how to create something like this. Okay, scratch that. Let me not say you will know how to create something like that, but because you will definitely know how to create this. This is what we are going to be creating in this tutorial. So yeah, I'm excited. I hope you are excited as well. So make sure you grab your laptop, because I always find it helpful, or I always find it easier to learn when you are watching and then you are also practicing on yourself. But that might just be me. But I find it easier to remember things when you are like learning, and then at the same time you are practicing yourself. So make sure you grab your laptop and then you follow along. So before we get started, I just want to ask you, if this is your first time or you haven't subscribed already by now, then make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of our video that we are posting. So yeah, let's get started. So to get started, I just want us to come into our desktop here. I just want us to come onto our desktop here and create a folder. And then let's create a folder. Let's just give it web layout. Just name it web layout. And then I want us to come inside our web layout folder there. Just maximize that. So in here, I want us to create, since in our HTML and CSS crash course, we only use Notepad as a text editor. So even on this, in this one, we are not going to be using any fancy text editor. We will just be using a Notepad. So let's just go in and open our Notepad here. Just come here, then click there, and then let's just type in Notepad. And it open up here, so just click on that to open it up. And then as you can see, is this one open up here, so I just want us to save it first. Make sure you are saving it in your web layout website there, the file name, since this is going to be our homepage, index.html. like I told you, if you remember in our HTML tutorial, I think our first tutorial for HTML, I told you that your index or your home page should always have an index name, and then your HTML file you edit with that .html extension. So the type, let's just put it to all file, and then the encoding UTF-8. If it was on this one, make sure you put it on UTF-8, and then you save. If you come into your folder there, you will see you cut your a file there, your HTML. Now I just want us to create our CSS file. So let's just create a new window there, and then let's save this. Save. And then this is going to be our style. A CSS file will have a CSS extension .css. The type just all file, and then the encoding UTF-8, and then you just save it. Now you got your two file. If you look into here, mine got this WebStorm icons there. That's because I got WebStorm installed in my machine or in my computer. I got WebStorm installed on my computer. So yours will probably have just a plain paper, but I don't stress about that. It will still just work fine. So the other thing that I want to explain to you is when you will be creating, let's say you are working on a bigger project, in your file here you always be needing to create at least, let's say, 3 folders in here in your root. Well, on your root folder here, you always be needing to create, to have at least 3 folder. The first folder, you will create the first folder where you are going to be keeping all your images. And then the second folder will be a folder where you will be keeping all your CSS files. And then the third one will be a JavaScript folder where you will be keeping all your JavaScript. And that's if you are working on a bigger project. But again, You can leave all your file in just in the directory here, but professionally or to make things look easier or easier for you to find, always make sure that you create a folder for your images, a folder for your CSS, and then a folder for your JavaScript. So in this tutorial, we are not going to be using any JavaScript, so we are just going to have, I just want us to create two folder. One, we call that an image, where we are going to be keeping our images, and then the other folder that I want us to create, I want to create a folder, and then this is going to be our CSS folder. Those two folders there. So now you just close off all this, our text editor here. Make sure you cross that off, and then let's just copy this, drag it, and then paste it into our CSS folder. Since this is our CSS file, as you can see, it's in there. Just make this big so that you can see your CSS styling, it's in there. So now I just want us to open this into our browser, since we are going to be using Google Chrome to our browser, and then I want to open it with my text editor, which is a notepad. Just going to be using a notepad, like I said. So you got your notepad there, and then you got your file open up in your browser there. So let's actually go ahead and create our HTML structure. So this is HTML5. You already know an HTML file should have a doc type, then HTML, and then close it off, and then you have your HTML opening HTML tag, and then close it off with your HTML closing tag. And then between your HTML tag there, come between there, you have to create your header tag opening, and then your closing header tag, and then also have your body tag opening, and then your closing body tag. So now inside your header tag there, you want to create to add your title. So you create your title tag, open and then close it off, close off your title tag, and then let's just say my website, let's say layout, and then control S to save. If you come into your browser, look up here, refresh, you see you now got your my title. This should be a title there. So sorry about that, title. Just control S to save and then refresh. So you see you now got your title there. So let's move on to now come into your body tag. So you know every this layout, we are going to be creating our header and then the main content, and then it should also have a footer. So we are going to start off with the header, and then what I want us to do is to just create, come in between your body there, create a div, open and then close it off, close that off, and then I just want to give this div an ID of, let's say, header. And then inside our header div there, we are inside our header div. We are inside our header div there. I just want us to add a div, to create a div inside there, and then close this div off. And then this div, let's just give it a class name, and then a class name, let's say main header. Main header there, and then inside our main header, I want us to add an h1, open and then close our h1, and then let's just give this my website, our h1 there, and then I want us to add our nav, and then let's just create our navigation there. So let's create a div, and then you close off your div, and then let's give this div a class name of, say, let's say nav. So this is going to be our navigation, and then inside our nav div, let's just add, create our URL there, URL, and then make sure you close it off, your unordered list there, and in between your unordered list, I want us to create our list item there, and then close it off, and then I just create a ring. You know how to create a ring, a drop, and then it's not going to be reading to anywhere, so just close that off, and then make sure you close your ring tag. And then in here we're going to give this, let's say this is our home page, and then to go fast, you're just going to copy this and then paste it down here, just to align, press tab on your keyboard and just paste it, control V to paste, and then let's say 4 times. So this is going to be your about, and then this is going to be your servers, and then the last one, let's say, will be your contact. So you create your simple navigation there. Now I want us to come outside of our header there. Outside, this is your header div, so I want to come down there outside, and then just create a new div, there, and then close this div off, and then I just want us to give this div an ID name. Let's say just top main. You can give it whatever ID name, it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to call that top main, and then in here I just want to add an h1, and then close our h1 off, and then just going to add, let's say, welcome to my web page. That's your h1 there, this div. Now I want us to come outside of our top main div down there, but we remember we are still inside our body tag there, everything is going between our body tag. So now I want us to create another div, a div, and then make sure you close it off. This is all just HTML. I hope you are not lost or anything. I know I might be going a bit fast, but yeah, just try to catch up. This div, I want to give it an ID. Let's just call this our wrapper, and then we come inside our wrapper div there. So we want to create in our div, we want to create a main content and then maybe a sidebar somewhere. So we want to, inside our wrapper there, let's just create another div and then close this div off, and then give this div, let's say, a class name, of main, let's say main bar, and then give it the second class name of bar. It got the main content bar, and then you gave it the second class name of bar. Make sure they are not together, because if they are together, that will treat it as one class name, so make sure they are separated. That's there. And in here, let's just say we want to add our h2, there, and then close it off, close off your h2, and then let's just give this to welcome, and then let's just add a p tag there, a p tag, and then close off your p tag, and then inside our p tag we're just going to add a couple of text. So what I will do, let's just go to Google there, and then just type in rorem. I just want us to grab a couple of text, just type in rorem, and then on Google there you can even just grab this here. Just want us to grab some random text, any text you can use, and then just come in between your p tag there, and then just paste it. So now let's just align this so that you can see them better. Align that, make them your paragraph, just align them there, align them. You see, this is not affecting anything. I just want to align them for this tutorial so that you can see it perfect. So you got your paragraph there. Now I'm just going to copy this paragraph and then paste it down here. So I want to have two paragraphs in our main div, then just paste it down there. So we are in our div there. Now inside our wrapper div, I want to create my sidebar. Remember, you are inside your wrapper div, but you are outside of your sidebar. Yeah, so there inside there, you want to create another div. And then just give this a class name of the first class name that you want to give it a sidebar. This was the main bar, now this is the sidebar, and then the second name you want to give it a bar. So I will show you later why I'm giving it two class name. They are got the same class name and then a different class name for each. So inside your sidebar there, I just want you to come to your paragraph here and then copy that and then paste it inside your sidebar there. Paste that there. And now I want us to come outside your wrapper div. You are outside, just in your body tag there. I just want us to create another div. So let's go ahead and close this div off. And then let's just give this div a class name. Let's say main contact. And then in here, I just want to add an h2. Then close our h2 off. And then let's just say contact us if you need our help. Just something simple. And then I just want to copy a couple of, let's say maybe this text here, copy that and then just create, let's say, a paragraph there. This is your p, close off your p tag and then paste it down there. So now what I want to create inside your main contact, I just want to create a simple form in there. Let's just create a form. You want to create a form, we know a form got its own form tag. Open and close form tag. And then inside your form tag, I just want to create, put in an input tag. Input the type, just want to make it a name, I mean a text, sorry, text. And then let's add a placeholder. Let's just say name. And then just copy this and then paste it down here. Press tab to align them perfectly. And then this is going to be email. And then I want to import a our submit button. Then so this is going to be input, and then the type I want to keep it as the submit, and then the name, let's say submit, and then the value I want to say submit form. Now just something simple. So now I want us to come outside of our main contact div there, but we are still inside our body, and then create our final div, and this is going to be our footer div, and then close it off. And then let's just keep this a class name of footer. It's going to be our footer. And then inside our footer, let's just create a p tag, open and then close your p tag off, and then just say copyright, add a couple of text, copyright, add copy 2020 my website layout, and then just side by me, myself, and I. So just something simple. Then you got all of this. So now Control S to save. Come into your browser. Let's just cross this off. Then refresh. So you see, you got all this. You got all this. So now, what I want us to do is start adding some styling. Since this is just pure HTML, so let's actually go on and add some styling. So what I want us to do is open our CSS file, come into here, into our folder. You open your CSS file, open it with your notepad there. Got your CSS file there. So the first thing that I want us to do is link our CSS file to our HTML. Ring to link it, do ring, and then the well, I want to keep it a style sheet, and then the age of, I want to ring it. It's our CSS file, it's in the folder called CSS, and then the name is style. So start off with the folder name, which is CSS / and then our file name, which is style.css, and then the final thing is the type, which is a text / CSS, and then close it off. So now this is how you link your CSS file to your HTML. Now let's come into our CSS, and the first thing that I want us to do is to actually just reset everything to zero, and then to reset everything, I want to reset our margin to zero, and then our padding to zero. Control S to save, and then I want to add some formatting to our body. So I want to, I want to use the font family. I don't want to use, if you check here, defaultly, this is Times New Roman. I want to use Tahoma. I'm a fan of Tahoma. So now if you come into your browser, refresh, you will see everything is now turned to Tahoma. So now let's actually style our header there. Go on to our header. So we know our header, it's in our folder, in our div. Our div is header, the ID is header there. So what I want us to do is come into our CSS, just call our ID, to call out an ID, which is header, and then I just want us to give it the width of 100%. This is colons, 100%, and then a height, let's say 70 pixel, and then the background color, let's make this black, and then our text color, let's make it white, and then our position, let's position this to relative. Control S to save, close it off with the semicolons, and then if you refresh, you see you got your header there. So now let's style our h1 and then our navigation there. So we know our h1 is in the div called with a class name of main header there. So if you want to make sure, just copy this, the class name there, come into your CSS to close a class, a point, and then just paste your class name there, and then here you want to give it, let's say, a width, let's say, of 96%, 96%, and then you want to add some margin. You want it to center it, some margin, which is 0 pixel outer. So that's what you want to do, and then you call your main, paste it, and then h1, you just want to, of our h1 there, you want to change the font size, let's make it to 20 pixel. Come into your browser, refresh there, you see it's now this small. So now what I want to do from here, I want to position my main header to position error or absolute. So let's just say position absolute, just want to position it absolute, and then give it some margin to the top, let's say to 20 pixel, and then margin left, let's say to 2%, since the width here it's 96. Supposed to change this to colons. So let's refresh there, you can see, you will see it there. So now what I want to do is add some formatting to our navigation here. As you can see, it's right here, so we want to display it in line and keep it this way. So now we know our navigation, it's in that class name called nav there. So let's just call it, go to our CSS, you call your nav class, and then you just want to format it. Let's say we want to position it, let's position it absolute, let's give it some width, let's say to 50%, and then let's give it some margin, we want to move it to the right, let's say to 5%. Come in here and then refresh, you see it's here. So now, so let's say we want to give it some margin to the top so that we can just align it perfect, just 5 pixel there, and then you refresh. So you see you got it there. So now we want to change the color of this, remove this restyling, and then display it in line. So what we're going to be doing, the first thing that we want to do is to target our nav rest. And then I want to display them, display inline block. If you display inline block, they should be displaying inline block. You see it there. Now you want to remove, so you want to remove your restyling. So restyle, you don't want it to have any restyle. You want to leave it to none, and then you want to now change the color and then remove these underlines here. So you can call your nav A, which is the ring. So the first thing is you want to remove the text decoration. You want to remove the text decoration. Text decoration, you want to leave it to none. And then the color, you want to leave it to white. Control S to save, and then refresh. So you got your color. Now you want to add some margin between them so that you can have space there. So you want to, in your nav list, you want to add some margin left, and you want to add, let's say, 30 pixel. See how 30 pixel looks like, and then you got your navigation there. So let's just make, let's say, 50 pixel, then refresh, we got your navigation there. So now Your navigation is done. So now you want to move to welcome to my web page here. So we know that it's in our top main here. So what you want to do there is come to your, just copy top main, which is an ID. Come there, come to your CSS file, and then call your ID. Paste your name there. So the first thing that you want to do is just give it the width of 100%, a height of 100 pixel there. So now the next thing that you want to do is text align. You want to text align, you want to align everything in the center. Then if you refresh, see, you got your text in the center. Then now you want to put some margin to the top there, and then add a background image. So first thing that we want us to do is to call main, and then call the h1. Just confirm if this is indeed our h1. Yes, it's h1. So you want to change the font size, let's say to 30 pixel there. Format it there. So now you want to add an image. So now you want to add an image to the background of this. So the image that I want us to use, I just want to go to Google, and then background image HD, and then I just want us to, you can choose any image, you can even choose, let's say, this image right here. So once you get, just grab that image there, just Control S, and then save it. So what I want us to do is to come into our web layout, and then I want us to save it into our images folder there, web layout, and then go into your images. Let's just give this a name of background. Make sure you are in your images there, and then save that. Then just close this off, then go to your folder, make sure you can find it, and then in your image folder there, just want to see if it's there. This is the image that we are going to be using there. The name is background. So now go to your CSS, since you want to add a background image. So you come into your top main. So you want to background image, and then you want to use the URL, and then your anchors are there. So now you are inside your your CSS folder. You want to go out of your CSS folder, and then go into your images folder, and then grab that background, which is the name of your image, .jpg. Just confirm the format of your image is a jpg. So now come back here, and then make sure you save. Now if you go to your file, to your browser, refresh, you see you got your image there, but they are repeating itself. So you can add some styling, and then change some styling to your text as well. So what you're going to be doing is just close this off with a semicolon, and then move it down. So now we want to change the background. Background position. We want to put it center top. and then we want to change the background repeat to no repeat, and then we want to background size, just move down, want to change the background size to cover. Control S to save. Come into your browser and then refresh to see you got your background image there. It's now in cover. So now you want to change the text of this of your main. So now what I want to do is just position these two, position our h1 to, want to add a position to relative, and then I just want to add, let's say, some padding to the top, let's say to 30 pixels, then refresh. So you can see you got your images there. Now you just want to change the color of your h1 there. Come into your h1, change the color, let's say to white, and then refresh. You got your welcome to my web page there. So yeah, let's just change the height of this of our top main. Let's say we want to give it to 130, and then change the padding top to 50. Now refresh. So you can see it's looking like that. Welcome to my web page. So now let's format our welcome and then all this. So now we know welcome, it's in a div called our wrapper. We first have to format our wrapper div here. Come in here into your HTML. This is your wrapper div. So let's add some styling to that first. So let's just call our wrapper div there, which is wrapper, and then with wrapper I just want to add some width, let's say to 96%, and then some margin. I just want to center it 0 pixel, outer, and then some position, just relative, and then it just add some padding, let's say top to, let's say, 30 pixels. Then come into your browser, refresh, got it there, padding. This is padding top, got it there. So now you want to format your main and then create your site there. Side nav there, we forgot to add something into our side nav. We're supposed to add an h2. Just come into your side nav there and then edge and h2, and h2, just say it, sidebar, just save. Come into your browser, refresh, and see you got your h2 there. So now let's add some styling to this, and then this, since we want this to be our main and then have our sidebar on this side. So going to our CSS, we're going to start off with our side, going to start off with our main bar. So let's just open this and then come into our CSS and then call it V main bar. I want to give it a width of, let's say, 55%, 55%. Then if you come in here and then refresh, you'll see it's now 55%. Let's just make this maybe 60, from 55 to 60. Coming to here and then refresh, you can see it's now looking like this. So now you want to add some margin here and then margin between your paragraph as well, and then put this your sidebar this side. So what you're going to be doing, you want to start styling your main h2. You want to, let's just say, your font size, you can say, let's say, want to be 18 pixel there, and then you want your main bar, then you want to style your p tag, which is your paragraph. You want to give it some margin top, let's say to 20 pixel. Come in there and then refresh. You can see you got your margin there. So now what you want to do is style your sidebar and then display there. So now you want to, you know, you got the class name, which is sidebar. You just want to give it a width, let's say, of, this is 60, let's say 25%, let's say 30%, right? And then you want to give it a background color of black, and then change the color of your text to white, and then give it some padding to 10 pixel. Right, Control S to save and then refresh. Come here, you'll see your sidebar is looking like this. So now you want to style your h1, h2, and this is your sidebar and your paragraph. Sidebar h1, with h1 you just want to change the text, you just want to change the font size to, let's say, make it 18 as well, 18 pixel. And then with the paragraph, you just want to use the same styling. Then this should be just a sidebar. Come into your browser there, refresh, you see it's looking like this. Now you want to bring this here. So what you will do is you just call your bar div there. They are both sharing the same bar class name, so you just call that class name dot bar, and then what you want to do is display them. So you want to display it in line block, and then come into your browser, refresh there. You can see you got it in line block there. So now you want to add some margin here. So just targeting your margin, your sidebar, you want to give it some margin to the left. Margin left, let's say to 20 pixel. Control S to save and then refresh. Then you got your sidebar there. I just make this maybe 30 pixel. You got your sidebar there. So now what you want to do is style your form there. So go on to main contact, the class of main contact. main concept. So just come into your CSS, then call your main concept. Just want to give it a width, let's say 100%, and then give it a background color. A background color, let's say of silver. And then you want to text align, let's say center. Control S to save. Come into your browser, refresh. You got your nav there. Now let's just add some padding to the top, maybe, and bottom. So to add some padding there, just move this down, then just add some padding you want to the top, let's say to 30 pixel. You want the ref 0, 30 pixel, and then 0. So refresh, got your padding there. Now add some styling to your page and then your form. So you just want to style your, let's say, main contact, your page tag there. Just want to, let's say, some margin to the top. Margin top, let's say to 10 pixel. And then you want to style your form, main form. You want to give it some margin to the top as well, to, let's say, 20 pixel. Out there, you refresh. See, you got it there. What I want us to do is to come into, before we move on, let's just add, let's say, some padding to this and put it some space down here. So I want us to come into our wrapper div there and then just give it some padding to the bottom as well. Padding bottom, and then just give it, let's say, 30 pixel as well, since we want to put some space down here. So you put in some padding and then refresh. Now you got your padding down there. So yeah, let's move on. Now let's add some styling to our form actually here. So call your form there dot main contact form. You want to start styling your input tag there. So you want to make the width you want to, let's say, to 20%, the height, let's say, to 30 pixel. You want to add some padding, let's say, to 5 pixel. Let me refresh. As you can see, you got your input there, and then it also formatted this. So what you want to target, you only want to target your input, not your submit button there. So you come down here and then just your square bracket, you want to target the type. You only want to target the type, which is a text. Carry brackets there and then text. So you refresh. See, you only targeted this. This one is the button hasn't been targeted. So now you got your name there and then your form there. So you want to target your submit button. Now to do that, just go on main form input. You want to target, this time you want to target the type. You want to target the submit, and then you want to, let's say, the background. background color, you want to make it black. You want to change the color to white. You want to add some padding, let's say to 5 pixels, and let's just say the height, you want to make it 30 pixels. Ctrl S to save and then refresh. Now got your button here, get your button, then now just want to remove this border of your button. So let's just move this down. So now you want to remove the border of your button, just make it none. So now you got your button and then your form there. So now let's move on to our footer. Your footer. So you know your footer, it's in a div, a class name called footer. Class name called footer. So you just want to add a width of 100%. Some padding, just want to give it some padding, let's say 30 pixel 0, and then you want to text align everything, text align to the center. Then if you refresh, so you're not seeing it, so you win to give it a background color. Give it a background color, let's say of black, and then color of our text white. Trust and then refresh. You can see you got your there to color. Change this, add the columns there, and then refresh. You got your footer there. So this got your header, your welcome page, your main, your sidebar, your contact form, your submit button, and then your footer. So yeah, you create a simple web page. Create a simple web page there. So yeah, that was it for this tutorial. I hope you find this video helpful. This video actually turned out to be longer than I expected it to be, but I wanted to cover everything and hopefully explain everything as I do. So yeah, I hope you find it helpful, and if you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if this is your first time, then please consider subscribing. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm out.